Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we are exploring Obduction. We are up here in the top of the building. I'm not sure what to call it. It doesn't actually have a name, and it doesn't look distinct enough for me to call it anything. It doesn't look like a, I guess, workshop? I guess we could call it a workshop. It's clearly where they built some, or put together, maybe not built. I highly doubt that they figured out how to build crazy alien technology on their own, but at least they put together, with the parts provided to them, some crazy weird alien technology stuff. So yeah, that's cool. In the last episode, we managed to turn the power back on, which allowed us to open the door right down there below me, and get up here. So we read some notes, got a little bit of story. Basically, our next goal, according to what Cecil told us, is that we need to destroy that red laser because it's doing something to the dome, and we need to stop that, and the blue laser will destroy the red device, so we need to get this machine down, basically. And also turning on the power gave us access to a whole bunch of other areas because now various doors around the place are unlocked. I doubt we can actually access all of them right now. But basically, we've got a lot to cover, so we're going to be trying to do a lot today and hopefully not mess it up. And did I actually... Hold up a second. There's some notes right there. Did I read these? Because I know I read the ones on this table. I don't think I noticed the ones over here. I don't think I did. Did I? Mayor's Imager requests. Entry Canyon, Farley's House, Center of Town, Tree, Water Source, Waterfall, Membrane, Wall/Cell, the Wall/Power, locomotive power generator, scrapyard/garage. Okay. Ambassador Seed, swap machine functionality. Radius or swap sphere is defined at first swap. Immutable. Seeds recharge naturally from ubiquitous ambient membrane power radiation tied to tree health. Forcing seed open triggers prep behavior. Radius demarcation. Small battery added to amplify ambient membrane power charges continuously. Parabolic focusing of power used to trigger seed swap behavior. Locking location or swap machines assures predictability. No unanticipated damage. Radius demarcation also occurs at same location in destination sphere. Without a pair seed defining the destination swap location, the destination coordinates coordinates match the source. Voila, swapping on demand. Okay, I don't understand any of what I just read. I kind of think this is all just techno mumble jumbo meant to sort of add a bit of realism to the idea of the all the machines that they've got, you know, basically to show that they know how they work. I get the feeling we're not expected to really memorize any of this, but just in case, take a picture. There you go. Maybe those will come in handy. And what is this journal for? Ooh, that's a lot of stuff. That's what that's for. Alright. Mofang Solid Volume Projector. Dimensional projector produces apparently solid apparitions with light, volume, and some sort of simulated mass. Buko says all projectors will have similar power levels and communication protocols. There appear to be three primary elements. Projector elements, beam emission. Projector element, beam emission, provides the primary light energy source. Control arms, some kind of control or the beam in three-dimensional color variable, and pass, invariable. Communications array, internal comm signals supplied across gap to project arms. Okay. 7 obus gap. Focus 22977. We'll use 7 volt communications level as a carrier voltage. Varying the voltage around that baseline voltage produces solid-like volume boxes in various colors formed from bottom to top, left to right. The Mofangs have turned the retrace timing to 30 EZ for unknightly kind of them. Timing to 30 Hertz for us. mighty kind of them. For a full 3D resolution of approximately 525 by 150 by 150, the converter would be required to adjust the voltage about every... Oh, is that it? It gets cut off there? Okay. Image bounding. Oh, so this is explaining how the image projectors work. Alright. Notes. Sound will be handled separately. Some projection noise, albeit... slight shimmer from radio interference. Moving image corruption noise toward bottom of projection. Images above projection are projection arm bounds are possible. Checking for potential hidden lethality, mere suggestion. Checks out. Can't find anything destructive. Consistent, spurious, very high frequency background waver. Carrier. No idea what that would be. Odd side effect. Projection intersecting any part of cell wall suppresses all transport. Be sure... Not sure why I tried this. Farley claims it's related to some desire of mine to shoot. Okay. Weird that the words keep getting cut off on the end right there. I'm not sure what that's all about. Looks like the... Actually, you can see words right here, too. That are also cut off by the black. And this diagram looks like it continues down. Can't pull the sheets of paper out or anything. So that's really weird. It's like somebody just stained the bottom of the pages black to cover up information or something. I'm not sure what that's about. Okay, again, more stuff that doesn't exactly look, like we'll need it, but just in case. Gonna take pictures of it, I guess. For smaller things that I need to remember, I prefer to write down notes, but I guess for huge freaking lists like those, there's no real reason to waste my time writing it all down, and your time on top of that. Alright, so first, let's go take a look at this thing. Obviously, it's some big puzzle contraption that we're gonna have to mess with at some point. Oh, and also, in the last episode, CW, the guy that we already had guessed was CW, confirmed that he was CW because he said people used to call him CW, and he also mentioned that his real name is Cecil. And if you guys maybe remember, back during the prologue of the game, when Farley was telling her little story, she was apparently talking to three other people. One of them was named Vera, one was named Cecil, and I don't remember what the third one was named. But so Cecil was one of the people who, at least at one time, was friends with Farley. Friends well enough for her to sit around and chat and tell them stories and stuff like that. So, since, as I have talked about several times before, Farley is kind of assumed to be trustworthy because she was the narrator and she also left a message trying to help us, and she sort of made, you know, an ominous comment about CW might be there, be careful who you trust, I don't know, blah blah blah. That sort of led us to believe that CW wasn't trustworthy, but now, based on the same logic, we honestly just don't know. And I'm honestly kind of sick of going back and forth and trying to guess whether or not CW and Farley and all these other people are trustworthy. I'm sure at some point in the game we are definitely going to have to deal with, you know, probably deciding to side with one person or another or something like that. Every Myst game so far has had elements of that. The original Myst had the two brothers, Cirrus and Akinar, who both told you that they were innocent and that the other one was evil, and you had to decide who to trust. And in the second game, Riven, there's the whole mess with Gen, where at the end of the game you eventually meet him, and he basically, you're told by other characters that he's evil, but then he tries to argue that no, he's totally not evil, he's just very misunderstood and he's changed his ways, and he used to be bad but no longer is, because being in solitude made him realize the error of his ways and everything like that. So every Myst game that I've played so far has had elements of the player having to figure out whether or not they can trust characters in the game. And this game opens up with Farley telling us be careful who to trust, so I assume at some point that's going to become relevant. But for now I'm going to try to avoid talking about it constantly, because that's exactly what I've been doing, talking about it constantly. Anyway, alright. Oh boy, this thing looks... Actually, it doesn't look all that complicated. Looks like we just gotta, like, put a battery or something in there and lock it closed. So let's read this, see what it says. Battery / capacitor log. Something... Something, something, something. New plug. Alright, I can't read that stuff that's all crossed out. Work begins on battery. Power test. No focal panels. First charging implemented. 10% charged. Focal teat. 2 focal panels. Efficiency changes implemented. Measured 19% absorption. Maximum. 50% charged. Bleeder completed. New secure plug. Critter proof. 100% charged. Bleeder switched on. Topped off charge. Fix focal panels built. Top heel off charge, topped 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 off charged. All focal panels built, topped off charge, topped off charge. Okay. Alright. Oh, okay, so that's... Okay, so we don't have to put anything in there by the looks of it. It's just... turn it on or not. I guess. That's far simpler than I would have imagined. There's probably something else that we have to do somewhere else, though, to get this working all nice and purdy. Can we interact with any of these things, or, any of these wires? I guess not. Alright, and this thing... How are we even gonna get this down? Because I don't see any... So far, at least, I don't see any, mechanism attached to it to let us lower it down. I'm not sure. Also, I have no idea what that did. So, alright, anyway. We got one more place over here to check. Though this could easily lead to many other places, so I guess we'll see. Oh, hey, you. You look good for lowering stuff down. And I can't get across there, okay. Cannot tightrope across the rail lines. Got it. Alright. Let's turn on the water, though. Nope. Okay, that is... Okay, it's leaking water. Is it leaking water when the thing's up like that? No, it's not. Okay. So I assume that's blocking the water, and I assume this lets water through. Alright. It's a very... God, I fucking love that. That's such a simple visual thing to show the player... that what they did changed something in the world. You turn a lever, water starts dripping from a pipe. Though actually, that end isn't connected to anything, so I guess... I mean, I guess there's already water in the silo, or whatever you'd call that. But, I don't think they can... get up new water anytime soon. Alright. You're still being a jerk. Can't do anything from this side, can we? No. Alright. This thing Oh, this must be the computer camera that they recorded all those messages with. Alright. Yeah, this obviously... Alright, yeah, that one's just a, like, demonstration. So nothing we can do with that. Alright, let's head back down. I pulled that lever thingy into place, and I don't know what it did, but maybe CW will tell us. Maybe he has an idea. Oh, and wait a minute, is there like a switch down here? No, doesn't look like it. It's so weird. Like, it's just not attached to any kind of contraption that would appear to let it down. So I don't know. I don't know what that's all about. We'll have to explore other areas, probably. Let's ask him first, though. See what he has to say. Uh-huh. Okay, never mind. Sorry to bother you, buddy. You call me a damn fool, but I'm completely new here. I haven't lived in this place for the last 30 or whatever years. I don't even know how long y'all people have been here. Clearly a long time. You in particular, though, I don't know how long you've been here. So, you know, I only just got here. I'm literally dealing with alien technology, Cecil. You could go a little easy on me, you know? Like, jeez. Alright. Maybe we have to pull these things out. Like, if we pull them over there to get over there, maybe that's something we have to do? Not sure at all. Alright. Oh, fucking hell! There's a button right here. There you go. Wow. I'm sorry I missed that. I'm really genuinely sorry, because the camera probably passed over it a few times, so you guys probably saw it. Especially if anybody here has already played this game. And I know that's always going to be a potential problem that people will have, where, you know, watching a... Can I... No, I don't want to take a picture. Okay. Oh, I have to open the door. Okay. Sheesh. Oh, this is cool. This is nifty. Okay, that's to aim the laser. Alright. Let's turn it on and off. How do we move forward now? Oh, how about that? Nope. That's to shut off the power. WASD or left stick. Yeah, I know. I don't need to... I'm not trying to... I need to move it out first. Alright, let's turn the laser on. Let's, yeah, we can't get to the red thing from here. Okay. Yeah, no, definitely can't, definitely have to do something else. Alright. Let's turn that off. Let's get out. And let's, because this thing... That thing, that looks like it has a lever on it, but we can't actually do anything with it, I guess? Wait a minute. Hold up a second. Actually, stop locking my camera to that. There you go. No, it's not gonna move. Alright, turn that off. What if we turn that off? Okay. I see. This actually makes some sense, because this lever is connected to two different wires, and the black wire Okay, both of them seem to go into the same space, so never mind. But there is a black wire right here, wrapped around this, connected to that. And that's a black wire, and that's and the yellow wire is probably for the other thing. Okay, so we have to get this turned around, basically. That's what we're doing now. Alright. So yeah, that switch doesn't turn anything off. That switch just changes our which part of the machine we're operating. Pretty nifty. Alright. Now how would we... Take a look around real quick. You know, I think we have to keep going for the moment. Because we have to... Yeah, up here. This should be good. I think. We'll see. We'll look. Oh, and hold up a second. Actually, is this You know what? Okay, switch to you. No? Okay, wow, I can't see a thing. Let's change that. Because I remember there were some rocks that had a red shimmer to them. And I guessed at the beginning of the game that they might have been... The red rocks might have been holograms or something? But... Because the red shimmer looked like these things, the image projectors. It looked like the same sort of red shimmer that you see on those when you're talking to folks. So if we hit those with the laser, will they just disappear? I think so. Okay, but how the hell do we get this to turn around? Yep, open up. Don't suppose there's another switch I'm missing to just turn it in place. I suppose that'd be kind of too easy, though, wouldn't it? Yeah, that's only for aiming the laser. Alright. Let's back it up. I switched the lever, so that should switch the track we go on. Alright. Let me turn around and look. Alright, I guess, let's just keep going. No, hey, move down. There you go. Okay. That doesn't look like it's going to accomplish anything. Okay, let's go forward again. And let's... Okay, hold up. Let's get out. I wonder what happens if we switch this to the left. It should, if I understand the physics of all this correctly, it should just stop us from moving that way entirely. Nope. It does not. Okay. Weird. But then when we back up, it goes the other way. Okay. Alright. Let me take a look around then. Alright. I think what we need to do is back up until it's at an angle right about here. Can we hit the... You know what? Okay, first, switch that. Alright, you look up, and now to your left. Yep, it's right there. And we got him. Okay. I knew that the, we couldn't really see the red rocks from here, but the head is forward. All right. And what's behind us? Let me go all the way back and check out. And those are just regular rocks, so nothing to do there. Okay. And that would lead us up to... Actually, that would lead us up to some more red rocks that we can hit. But we gotta get out for... Oh, the thing's blocking the way. Damn it. Alright, move forward. Move forward a bit more, because there's another rock right there, too. Actually. No, let me out! You damn thing! Oh my god. Fine. Move forward a lot more, I guess. Jesus. Such a finicky little thing. There! Let me out now. What? Oh, come on! Those rocks are tiny! Just let me out! I mean, I understand that the developers don't want you to get caught. If you try to step out of this when it's too close to a rock, you might, like, you know, you might get stuck in the environment in between the thing and the rocky bit. But still, jeez. Alright, and actually, let's go run up here real quick. I'm gonna take a quick look. Because that would actually, that would take us over there in front of her house. But we'd be going backwards. I want to try and visualize this to get a good idea of everything. Alright, and there were... Yeah, these rocks up here are red. So if we angle this correctly, we should be able to hit those. And remove them. That's just a dead end. And we'd be facing... We'd be facing forward that way when we come over here. But if we come down this path, we'd be facing forward that way. And then take us over here to the house. And you know what? While I'm in front of the house, I'm going to find Marlene's address. Because that is... Farley's address. 1436. Let's write that down, because in the last episode, from reading one of the notes, we know that the... door code is her address backwards, so 6341. Got it. Thank you. Thank you for that, game. Alright. Now, alright, if we go backwards... Why is my shadow on? I turned character shadows off, you piece of crap. Character shadows off. Yeah, what the hell? Thank you. No unnecessarily hitting my frame rate. Remember my settings, damn it. Anyway, so yeah, we'd be facing backwards that way, and then we could go forward up here. And then the blue laser could hit the shield? I don't think that would do anything. But maybe. Maybe. Alright. Well, let's do one thing at a time. Let's go over there, because we've already got the tracks all set up in place to bring it forward over towards the place where we first saw the glow bug. So let's go do that first. Back it up. All the way. Alright, now forward. We've already pressed that lever, so now we'll go left. This is exhilarating. Truly. Alright, I think right about here. Maybe up a little more. Alright. Now let's try and hit them rocks. There you go. We got him. Hell yeah. Alright. Switch that off. It's back all the way up. Now I think, if I remember correctly, I thought I remember there being a third thing of red rocks. But I can't quite remember. Oh, actually, hold up a second. Let me get out here so I can switch the lever. There you go. Now let's get back in. But if there was a third thing of rocks, I can't remember where they are now. Suppose I should have made a better mental note of that. I don't know. Also, I should, of course, keep an eye out for other Mofang technology, since that blue laser is designed for destroying it. And, although not necessarily necessary, it could be. Could be the possible solution to any old puzzle. Alright, back up. Back it up! All the way. And now, forward. Let's see what this does to that barrier. I highly doubt it'll do anything, but you never know. You never know, do ya? Actually, it'd be kind of funny. I'm just gonna guess here. What if, like, the blue alien technology is capable of going through that barrier? Nope. Okay. Turn this on. Turn that on. Nope. Yep, just like I thought. Doesn't do anything. Kinda wonder why there's a track over here, then. Maybe just a coincidence. Could easily just be a coincidence. Oh well. Alright. Now let's go back in front of Marley's house. Farley's house, I'm sorry. I don't want to keep calling her Marley. I think that's like the second or third time I've done that. Alright. Get out. Get out! Jeez! Frame rate, please. Alright. Let's go back this way. Let's go back over to the, other thingamajig thing over there. But, we're gonna do that in the next episode, because I'm at now all out of time for this one. So I hope you all have enjoyed this, and I hope you will continue to enjoy it, and I will see you all next time, where we'll go and continue to try and blow up the red laser. Buh-bye.